There are very exciting and wonderful days ahead for the overcomers. By that term, I mean Christians who endured to the very end. Listen to what God's Word says in Revelation 21, 1 through 8. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." He said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning, the end. To him who is thirsty, I will give the drink without cost from the spring of the water of life. He who overcomes will inherit all this. I will be his God and he will be my son. But the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those who practice the magic arts, the idolaters and all liars, their place will be in the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death." Let me draw your attention in upon verses 7 and 8 again. That passage says this: "He who overcomes will inherit all this, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. But the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those who practice the magic arts, the idolaters, and all liars, their place will be in the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death." The word "but" at the beginning of verse 8 helps distinguish that verse from the first seven verses of Revelation 21. Notice, please, that verse 7 describes the overcomer, that is, he who actually enters God's paradise kingdom. The overcomer will inherit the new heaven, the new earth, the holy city, New Jerusalem, and this paradise environment where there will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain. He will also forever be God's son, which is also a powerful refutation to the false idea on Mormonism that man can become a god. The overcomer will never be a god, but instead always be a son of God. If one is not an overcomer, then the only other possibility is he will be a non-overcomer, as referred to in verse 8. The cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those that practice the magic arts, the idolaters, and all liars. Please notice the following insights from verse 8. 1. It won't just be the unbelieving that will go to the lake of fire in the end. According to this passage, the cowardly, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those who practice the magic arts, the idolaters, and all liars will also be there. This fact is a powerful refutation to the eternal security proponents who think the only sin that will damn one is a continuous unbelief in Jesus. 2. The cowardly or fearful in verse 8, though not clear, probably refers to those that were too afraid to initially confess Jesus as their Lord or renounced their faith in Jesus during a time of persecution. Such would be consistent with other scriptures. 3. All murderers will go to the lake of fire unless they repent and get forgiven like King David did after his sin of murder. Hence, if you're thinking about suicide or self-murder, stop pondering the devil's thoughts now. He is trying to destroy you with such thoughts and imaginations. Remember, there is no eternal security or once saved, always saved. 4. People involved in the occult will be thrown into the lake of fire unless they turn from such wickedness and get forgiven. This is important to know, especially in a day when Harry Potter is exalted as a hero type figure. The truth is, Harry Potter, if he was a real person, would be headed for the fiery lake of burning sulfur for his witchcraft. If your children or grandchildren aren't aware of this important truth, please inform them now, especially since the public schools are not speaking out on the dangers of witchcraft. You also shouldn't allow your loved ones to see Harry Potter movies or read books about this wickedness. They will get no spiritual blessing from such. 5. Did you notice the clarity of verse 8, which says all liars will go to the lake of fire? What a surprise this must be to many who regularly lie and don't think anything about it. Some even think everyone is a liar. I've talked with eternal security proponents that think like that. If it was true that all people are liars, then all people would go to the lake of fire in the end, and no one would ever enter or inherit God's paradise kingdom. 6. There is no third place for people to go, such as purgatory would be. One will either be an overcomer, or he will be thrown into the lake of burning sulfur in the end. Imagine that. A lake, but not a lake with water in it, but instead sulfur burning with raging fire. This is where all people described in Revelation 21:8 will go. If you are described there, you must repent and get forgiven, or you will miss the blessings designed for the overcomer and will instead go to this horrible place. 7. Since a non-overcomer is described in verse 8, then we can safely assume the overcomer is one not described by those sins listed there. 8. The word overcomer suggests there is something to overcome. The context shows that would be sins such as cited in verse 8. We can overcome with God's help. Again, we can overcome, but the devil will certainly try hard to see to it that this will never occur. Listen again to those stirring verses. He who overcomes will inherit all this, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. But the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those that practice the magic arts, the idolaters, and all liars, their place will be in the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death. Enduring to the end for salvation's sake is not only important because of what you get, but also because of what you don't get. God bless you.
Today, we often hear wicked people tell others to go to hell. We advise you not to go to hell. The only way to escape this eternal, conscious torment is to place a trusting and submitting faith in the Lord Jesus for your salvation. Ask God to have mercy on you. Turn from all your sins. Obey the Holy Bible. Follow Jesus until death. We have materials that can help you spiritually. Call us today at 724-632-3210. That's 724-632-3210. And ask for a free packet of ministry materials. Join us in the fight for souls by sending your tax-deductible donation to Evangelical Outreach, P.O. Box 265, Washington, P.A. 15301. P.O. Box 265, Washington, P.A. 15301. We need your financial help and prayers. Thanks, and God bless you.